God, doesn't he know about her allergies? Here's what you have to do. You have to call me tomorrow as, give me 2 seconds, as soon as they get back and let me know exactly what happened. Bye. I'm so excited for you. Bye. Hey, sorry about that.
Miss Campanella, this publicity campaign is to be run with military precision. It is to be timely, quantifiable, and orotund. Do you know what that means?
No.
I warn you, these are actors. In every actor, there lives a tiger, a pig, an ass, and a nightingale. You never know which one's gonna show up. Don't make assumptions about the talent. Don't assume that the talent can hear well. Don't assume they know the plot of the film. Don't assume that they have living parents. Don't assume that they don't have a drop of Indian blood. Question, do I look like I have Indian blood?
Not at all.
Question, would it surprise you to learn that I am 1/8 mighty Choctaw?
It would.
Question, would it astound you to learn that here on the set, I am Corey Taft, but when I'm at home, I'm JoJo.
So, this is gonna be great. One more time.
Whitney? Hi there, can I talk with you for a moment?
Oh, yeah.
Hi, you okay in there? Not interrupting a meal or anything.
No. Sorry, I'm on this thing. I hurt my back. I fell over the side of an escalator.
Great. Whitney, I have to tell you that I have been a publicist for 20 years, 15 and 5 strapped to the gurney. I have never experienced the hostility that this little picture, which I think is a charming show, is engendering in the community. I've had hang-ups. I've had rude responses. That's not where I'm getting on this one.
That's not good, but you know what? It's all right, because we should go a whole different angle that no one's even thought of.
Okay.
What if we go on the angle of, let's play it down, let's tell people not to see our show?
That's a dangerous sell.
Put a big ad in the paper and say, don't come.
Okay, true enough. But as my proud ancestors, the Choctaw, say, what we're dealing with on this picture is Bunha Ko'a'a. Difficult to translate it. Basically, we don't have a blanket. We don't have a blanket for a... It's a diuretic pony. A urinary problem pony to piss on. Mm. Excuse me.
This is so stupid, and I'm sorry to bother you, but I just wondered, apparently there's something on the internet. Somebody had been on the set here at Home for Purim and brought up the idea of there being a possibility of a nomination for an Oscar. And it's nothing, it's a big deal. Who cares? I mean, it's no big deal. It's nothing. Forget it.
Okay.
I just thought, you know, because...
All right.
If you Googled Simon Whitsett, apparently you could...
Okay, this is a rumor that's out there on the internet, and you think it's nothing. Tell you what, I'm gonna look into it. This could be very interesting indeed. Okay, quick question. The internet, that's the one with email, right?
Yes.
Got it? I'm on it. Wasn't the apple in the tree, but the pear on the ground that caused all the trouble. Morning, kids.
Hi, Corey.
Big day?
For her, it is. She shoots her big scene with Marilyn.
Big day for all of you.
No, I have like 2 exteriors with Victor and then I'm done.
Aha. You haven't heard the rumor?
No.
Do you kids like to use the worldwide interweb?
The internet? The internet.
We do. We know what it is.
Well, there was an item published on the...
internet.
And it mentions very favorably this little picture. And in particular, your colleague, Marilyn Hack.
Aww.
It's good for her.
That's so great.
In further... particularly notice a possible Oscar nomination.
For Marilyn?
For That's Marilyn
so
Hack.
Cool.
For Home for Purim?
Home for Purim.
That's great.
That's great for her.
Chew upon that.
See you, Corey.
Yep.